Hey everyone, welcome back to another Mining Chamber video. In today's video, we are going to be building the 5700 XT mining rig. We just recently got 6 of the Sapphire Nitro Plus models, so we're going to be putting it together in this video, and then we're also going to discuss how much this mining rig costs, so all the hardware included in the mining rig, and then also how much money can it make for you, and how much hash rate are you expected to get, and how much watts is it going to use from the wall. And then we will also briefly cover topics like the BIOS modding and then overclocking. We did do a video on the 5700 XT where we covered everything in detail. So BIOS modding step by step, overclocking, and what you should do if it keeps crashing and everything like that. So we won't be going too deep in that, since you can just watch that other video, which we will leave in the descriptions below. But if you do have any questions, please leave it in the comment sections below, or you can feel free to join us in our Discord server and chat with us there. So thank you guys, and we hope you enjoy the video. Before we build the mining rig, let's first calculate how much money it costs us to build this mining rig, and then we can evaluate when we will make our investment back and dive into the profits of the mining rig later on. All of these prices will be evaluated in US dollars. First, we will start with the GPUs. We were able to get a really nice deal on the GPUs. We got them refurbished from Canada Newegg for $475 Canadian each. Plus the tax will add up to around $500 Canadian. When we transfer that to USD, then it comes out to around $380. So for 6 GPUs, we were able to get them for a total of $2,280. As for the risers, we are using the Ubit risers, which we got the 6-pack for $40. The motherboard we are using is a BioStar TB250 BTC Pro. We got that off of Amazon for $55, and we are using the Intel Celeron G3930 CPU and one stick of 8GB RAM, which both costed for a total of $60. As for the storage, we are just using 120GB SSD that we got for $15, but eventually we might end up changing it and then switching it to a Linux-based mining system that runs off of a USB thumb drive. For our mining frame, we are using a 6 GPU Vera frame, which we graciously got from Red Panda Mining. He sent us a couple of them a while back, and we really appreciate him for doing it. So please subscribe to his channel if you haven't yet. He releases a video every day, and he releases great content that you can benefit from. Now for the PSU, it was the hardest part to get since all the prices have got pretty high, but we are extremely lucky and grateful because one of our Discord members, Eric, was kind enough to sell us a P2 1200 watts PSU for only $110. Usually these tend to cost almost $300 new, so that helped us to save a good amount of dollars on the mining rig. Thank you again if you're watching this video, Eric. We also have a couple of splitters that go with the power supply that we received from nerdgears.com, and we do recommend you to get them from there. They offer them at a really good price for only $2 per splitter, and since we are using 9 of them, we will round up the cost to $20 for the splitters. As for the cooling and aesthetics, we are using the Deepcool fans, RGB, which will complement the look of the build really nicely. We were able to get the 5-pack for only $35. Now after adding up all the hardware, the total cost comes out to $2,615. So if you are looking to build a similar mining rig, just remember that the prices may vary. We were able to get a couple of nice deals, which saved us a good amount of dollars. But if you would have to buy it brand new for every part, then the bill will most likely be around $3,000 to $3,500. Now let's run the time lapse of building the mining rig, and then we will bring to attention important information that we think you should know if you're building a 5700 XT mining rig with very similar parts. Okay guys, so now we finished the build, but there's a couple of things we think it's worth mentioning to guide you when you build a similar mining rig. So the first thing is, if you are using the same motherboard, make sure to power the Molex ports on the motherboard itself, because it is what provides power to the PCIe slots. And also always make sure to install the latest drivers for your motherboard, and also flash the BIOS if it is outdated. You can find more information about this on the motherboard support and drivers page. For powering the GPUs, what I usually like to do is plug in a splitter in two risers and a splitter in both 8 pins of the GPU if you have a 2 8 pin model. If your power supply has enough connections that you end up not needing a splitter for each GPU, then that is great. We will make a video soon to get in depth about power supply connections and how to connect everything together. And then the last thing, we will install the GPUs one by one so we can BIOS mod them first. So as you can see here in the build, we didn't install all of them, we just installed one GPU, we kept everything else disconnected as of now. And then we'll just keep BIOS modding and saving the original BIOS and then move on to the next card. We will cover that more later on once we reach that section. So now we will plug in the USB stick that we will use to install Windows 10 on our miner. To make a bootable USB for Windows 10, you just need to use the media creation tool or just burn a Windows 10 image on the stick. And then like that, you can just install Windows and do all the setup that you need. So the first thing you need to do once you have it installed is go through the optimization steps that we covered in one of our videos, which was the top 5 must-do tips for Windows 10 mining. We will leave the link for that video in our descriptions below. After finishing the optimizations, we will install the required applications to start modding our GPUs. We won't be going in depth about this here since we did cover it fully in our last video, where we went over the 5700 XT profitability, BIOS modding, and overclocking. So in this video, we will just mention important things to keep in mind when BIOS modding more than one GPU. The first thing you want to make sure you do is to save the original BIOS of each GPU accompanied by a unique identifier to that specific GPU. It can be either the last 4 digits of the serial number, or if you choose to label your GPUs with a sticker where you can stick it on the backplate of the GPU. Whatever method you choose will work as long as you can match the original BIOS that you save to the GPU. In our example, we will be using the serial number of the GPUs that can be found in the bottom of the Sapphire Nitro Plus model. Without BIOS modding, we were getting around 52 mega hash and using 145 watts off the wall per card. So now after BIOS modding, we should be getting around 55 mega hash and around 130 watts off the wall. Now after setting up all the BIOS mods, what we need to do next is plug in every GPU and then run the overclocks and see if it's stable on all of them. So before that, let's first cable manage the rig and then we can get started with the overclocking. We had to troubleshoot the mining rig for a little while to figure out what overclock settings are stable, and now we finally got almost all the GPUs stable at around 725 to 800 millivolts and 1780 to 1800 memory frequency, and then 1300 core clock, and only one of the GPUs refuses to abide any overclocks. It shows that it is set at 725 millivolts like the other GPUs, but it keeps consuming more than 725. It keeps consuming around 1150 millivolts, so I will need to troubleshoot that one further, but as of now we know that it is taking more watts than it should be. Now let's see the numbers we will get in Phoenix Miner. So we are averaging around 55 megahash per GPU. We have a total of around 330 megahash. And we are using 130 to 135 watts average per GPU, but that one GPU that is having troubles overclocking and it's giving us 53 megahash and it is consuming about 100 watts extra than the other cards. So the total system off the wall is currently reporting at 950 watts total, but after we get the GPU fixed up, we will be able to get the entire system watts to around 860 to 880 watts. So now let's take these values to whattomine.com and see how are the returns looking for this mining rig. Okay everyone, so now we are on the whattomine.com calculator and we're looking here at the Ethereum coin. It is one of the most popular coins to mine with the 5700 XT. The first one being Ethereum Classic, but Ethereum Classic has been having troubles lately, so we will just stick for Ethereum for now. So we went ahead and put in the 330 megahash that we can make from this mining rig and then the 880 watts that it takes to run it, and as well as the electricity of 0.1, which is 10 cents per kilowatt hour. So we can go ahead and hit calculate and then we will be able to see how much money we can make with this mining rig. So as we can see here, we are able to make $14.54 every day. That's profits after the electricity costs of 10 cents per kilowatt hour. And then we can also see here that in 1 month we will be able to make $436 profit, or $499 in total without electricity costs. So in general, looking at these numbers, you can see that it has a really good return. Even though the electricity cost is at 10 cents, it still can make your money back in less than a year. So in 1 year, you're predicted to make $6,000 if Ethereum sticks to this price. And if Ethereum price does go higher, then your return will be a lot quicker. But as of now, definitely really good numbers. It's impressive how much this mining rig can make back. It is more on the pricey end. This mining rig is not the cheaper ones. It's not a budget mining rig, but it is one of the good options out there that I do recommend for people to build if you are looking into building a mining rig. If you have any questions regarding this mining rig or anything we missed, please let us know in the comment sections. And we are also planning to switch this mining rig to a Linux-based mining operating system because we noticed that in Windows 10 it was having too much trouble, it was unstable, and it took a while to get it set. So whenever we end up switching to one or deciding for which one we should switch, we will let you guys know, and then hopefully we can go through it together and be able to guide you guys on how to switch your mining rig to a different operating system. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, let us know in the comment sections below. So by the time you guys are watching this video, we might have hit 2,000 subscribers or we're very close to it. So we want to thank you guys for getting us here and reaching us to 2,000 subscribers. It's really crazy and we appreciate all the support. So hopefully in our next video, we want to announce a giveaway for our 2,000 subscribers milestone. So thank you guys again and we hope you have a wonderful day.